My beloved, I bless the Almighty Lord for your presence. I bless the Almighty Lord. Like I always say, you could have been doing anything else. There are other people right now, they've taken this time to watch TV. They've used this moment to do whatever other things. But you've left your house to seek the face of God. And may he truly reveal himself. I bless the pastoral couple once again for this moment to be able to stand before you. Here where we are standing, it cannot be given to just anyone. Because here there's life and death. So to be given this opportunity, I'm truly eternally grateful. And may the Lord return many to you. Amen.
Amen.
Today we are going to the book of Numbers 6. Numbers 6. Now our main verse will be verse 25. Numbers 6, 25. But what I will do is, I will read 24 to 26. Just so that we can have a better understanding. But where you are, note that verse 25 is the main verse. And the version I will be reading is the Amplified Version. Amen.
Amen.
We know what we must do when we're about to hear the first word. Amen.
Amen.
Are we ready to hear the word?
Amen.
I read number 6.
Nombre 6.
24 to
26.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you, protect you, sustain you, and guard you. Verse 25, Amen. The Lord make his face shine upon you with favor and be gracious to you, surrounding you with loving kindness. The Lord lift up his countenance face upon you with divine approval and give you peace, a tranquil heart and life. Amen.
Amen.
Father in heaven, we bless you for your word. We surrender this time, this moment into your hands. May your mighty spirit lead. May your mighty spirit move in Jesus' mighty name. Anything that is not of yours, Lord, it is uprooted in Jesus' mighty name. Because where you are, Lord, there is the absence of the enemy. And therefore, as you are reigning, may you be the only one in Jesus' mighty name. We pray and we say amen.
Amen.
You may be seated in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
I bless the Almighty Lord for this opportunity.
Amen.
Amen. Now the book of Numbers that we have read. In verse 25. In other versions. In this one it says to us. That the Lord make his face shine upon you with favor. And be gracious to you. Surrounding you with loving kindness. In other versions, it says, may the Lord smile upon you. And be gracious to you. Amen.
Amen.
Now just to give the background of what we have read. In my version, what we have read is called Aaron's benediction. And in other versions, it's called the priestly blessing. Now here the Lord was telling Moses to tell Aaron and his sons that they how they should bless the children of Israel. This was because Aaron was a high priest.
Oui,
and this is how God wanted him to bless the people. And then the Lord said to Moses to tell Aaron that if he's to bless the people in his name, then the people will be blessed. Amen.
Amen.
So my message for today, my beloved, it is entitled, Lord, let your face shine upon me. Amen.
Amen.
I repeat once again, Lord, let your face shine upon me. I'm going to try my best to be short, because I want us to take time to pray. Now, when we are asking for the Lord's face to shine upon us, what does it mean to shine, my beloved? When looking at the definitions, to shine is to give out a bright light. To shine is to glow. It is to be bright. To shine, it is to direct light in a place where there is darkness, so that you are able to see. Now the Hebrew word for light is or. It's spelled
O-R,
which means to give light or to shine. To shine, my beloved, it means to illuminate. When something is illuminating, it is revealing what was hidden. It is removing what is of darkness. Now in Numbers 6:25, I'm going to read it again. The Lord is saying, the Lord said, the word says, the Lord make his face shine upon you with favor and be gracious to you, surrounding you with loving kindness. So the Lord is saying that his light, when his face is upon you, it will shine upon you, so that you are also a light. And when you are lit by God, when the Lord's face is shining upon you, you then also begin to shine. Which is why the theme today is, Lord, let your face shine upon me. We are seeing the way the world is going, my beloved. And the first lady said it when she was here. It is only going to get worse, all the things we are seeing. The darkness is accelerating in a way that we can't even comprehend. But for those of us who have Christ, for those of us who know the Lord, we must be a light in a world of darkness. Even in a world where darkness is reigning, even in a place where darkness is trying to penetrate, the light of the Lord to be upon your life, so that you are not consumed by the darkness. Amen.
Amen.
Now, why is it that we want the light of the Lord to shine upon us? Why do we want his face to shine upon us? It is simply because we do not want darkness to reign in our lives. As I said, we do not want to be consumed. with what is of darkness. Because what the enemy likes to do, he wants to use the darkness to cover what the Lord has put in us. He knows that where he is going is hellfire.
It's
a darkness. And he doesn't want to go on his own. He wants to take us with him. That we are praying today that the face of the Lord will shine upon us. So that we are not dragged into the darkness. So that we are not consumed by the things that are dark in this world. We do not want to be consumed by the enemy. The Bible tells us that the battle, it is not with flesh and blood. It is with forces of darkness. And the first lady said it. She gave the book of Ephesians 6 verse 12. And the Bible says, so our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the powers, against the world of forces of darkness, against the spiritual forces of wickedness in the heavenly places. So the Bible is telling us that what we are up against is forces of darkness, powers that reign in the dark, powers that move in darkness, powers that move in evil. And the only way we are able to overcome the forces of darkness, the powers of darkness, the only way we will stop darkness reigning in our lives is the light of the Lord is upon our lives. If the face of the Lord is shining upon us, you will not be consumed with these evil rulers, with these evil people that operate in the darkness. Because the light of the Lord in you, it will divulge their plans. You will be overwhelmed and overwhelmed. But separate yourself from darkness. If you're in darkness, that's why we are asking for the light of God to shine upon us, to make that separation. We're
going
to go into the book of Genesis 1. Genesis 1, verses 1 to 4. I'm going to read it in Jesus' name. Now listen to these words carefully. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was formless and void, or a wasted emptiness, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, primeval ocean that covered the unformed earth. The Spirit of God was moving over the face of the waters. And God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. God saw that light, the light, this is the bit I like. God saw that the light was good. And in brackets they put pleasing or useful. And he affirmed it and sustained it. And God separated the light, distinguishing it from the darkness.
Amen.
So that's what I say.
Yeah.
We need the light of the Lord to shine upon
our
eyes. Because how can you overcome what is dark? If you are in darkness, my beloved, as we have read in the book of Genesis 1, the empty, the world was empty and void. It was in darkness. Then the Lord said, "Let there be light." And he even said, when the light came, that the light was pleasing. He made that separation. He made that separation. And as children of God, we must be separated from what is of darkness. There must be a distinguishment. The Bible says in Malachi
3:18,
then you will again distinguish between the righteous and the wicked, between who serves God and those who do not serve
Him.
So the Lord is saying that there must be a distinguishment between what is of light and what is of darkness. If you want to be different from this world, if you want to be distinguished, you need the light of God to shine upon your light. In this world of darkness, you must be different.
So
the light of the Lord is in your life. What is your life?
In
the same as those who are in darkness. You know Jesus Christ. You have accepted Him as your Lord and Savior. And the Bible says He is the light of the world. So if you have accepted the light of the world in your life, you must live a life of distinguishment, live a life of difference. What is of darkness, there must be a separation.
Amen.
Now the word is saying, in the beginning, as we said, God made a separation between light and darkness. And when I was reading this, my beloved, I thought to myself, we know that the Lord is omniscient, which means He knows it all. And that means when He created man, He knew that they would sin and they would fall and they would be removed from God's presence.
and be in darkness. But from the very beginning, even though God knew that would happen, He already made
a
separation
between
light
and darkness,
because He knew that one day Jesus
Christ
would come
and
the light of the world
to
separate us
from
what was of darkness, which is why, my beloved, we want the face of God to shine upon us. Jesus Christ, He came to make that separation where sin, where curses, where all the evil things that the enemy was dragging us back in darkness. There was no way that then Jesus Christ, He came as a way and pulled us into the light so that we could see the glory of the Lord, which is why, my beloved, we want the face of the Lord to shine upon us so that we can be separate from all that is of darkness. And I want, where you are right now, say to the Lord, God, I want to walk in your light. God, I want to walk in your light. I want to be separated from all that is of darkness, from all that is of disorder, from all that is of lacking. I want to walk in your light. In Jesus' mighty name, the face of the Lord to shine upon us. You must be different. When we have the light of the Lord, it is not only for us our own, but it's also for us to share it with others. When you're walking in the light of God, you need to impact
under
that light that you've received from God, that you've received from Christ. When you're walking in the world, whosoever will encounter you, that light must have impacted them also, so that if they were in darkness, so that they can come into the light also, which is why I want to declare right now, my beloved, man, as you walk in the light of God, whosoever will encounter you, may that light impact the disorder.
one.
The obstacles in the way of the door to heaven. Now, how can you overcome those obstacles? If you cannot see them. But when you have the light of God, you will be able to see what is before you,
right?
And you will be able to overcome. The Bible says in Psalms 119, verse 105, your word is a lamp to my feet. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. Meaning where there is disorder, meaning where there is darkness, meaning where you cannot see, if you have the light of God, you will be able to see where you are going. You will be able to avoid all the obstacles before you. Where the world is seeing no way, because they're in darkness, you will see a way. Because the Lord Jesus, maybe you feel as if you're in darkness. The Lord will be the light that will guide us to reach where He wants us to reach. The Lord will be the light to allow us to do what He wants us to do. He will allow us to reach the destination. The sadness of this world, they can guide you, but it can only take you in the ways that it knows. And the ways that it knows it's come from humans. It's humans that have programmed it so that we can then be guided. But when the Lord is your light, when the Lord is the one guiding you, His light will show you ways where there is no way. His light will shine paths where there is no paths. Sometimes when I'm in a sadness, I'm using it. You reach a road, it's confused. It's telling you here's the destination, but there's nothing. And maybe even if it takes you somewhere, where you need to be is over there. And it doesn't know how to get there because the car can't go through that way. But when I say that the Lord is your light and He is the one lighting your path, there will always be a way to go. He always light a path for you. So I declare right now in Jesus' name, may the light of the Lord guide you. May the light of the Lord guide you. May it guide you forward. May it guide you higher. May it guide you to where the Lord wants for you to be. We declare that this year is a year of placement. It is the Lord who will shine His light upon you so that you can reach where He wants for you to reach. Even if there's darkness, my beloved, may you be able to see in Jesus' name. Even if there is disorder in this year of 2020, the year of disorder, receive so much darkness that may it not suffocate your light. Even in the midst of chaos, may your light shine in Jesus' name. Can we please applaud for the Lord?
Amen.
We want the face of the Lord to shine. One thing you need to know about light, my brother, is that it is powerful. I gave you the analogy that if I turned off this light and we're in pitch black, we can't see anything. But with my phone, even if I put my torch, it will still, I will still be advantaged because that torch, it will allow me to see, it will still allow me to go. And that's like the light of the Lord. And even if the darkness is filled
wherever,
the light of the Lord will ensure that you are able to make your way around.
Amen.
Amen. Now, scientifically speaking, they say that nothing can travel faster than light. Now, if the people of this world, they can recognize the speed of light, or they can recognize the force that is light, what about us Christians that have the light of God, the light of the Lord, that is an unstoppable force? When the light of God begins to spread, nothing, my beloved, and I say nothing, can stop the light of
penetrating where there is darkness, mean that if the face of the Lord is shining upon you, when you are lit by the light of God, you also become an unstoppable force. That the enemy doesn't want for us to shine. Because he knows that if you're in the light, you saved not only yourself, but your family, your children, people around you. Amen.
Amen.
And he wants us to remain in darkness.
He doesn't
want us to shine in the light of
God.
Because like I said before, he doesn't want to go to hellfire by himself. Now in the book of 2 Corinthians, verse 4, 2 Corinthians 4,
verse 3,
here the Bible tells us, but even if our gospel is hidden, it is hidden only to those who are perishing.
That's right.
Among them, the God of this world, Satan, has blinded the minds of the unbelieving to prevent them from seeing the illuminating light of the gospel of the glory of God, who is the image of God.
Amen.
So here the Bible is saying
that
the devil is trying to blind everyone with his darkness so that we do not benefit from the light that Jesus Christ brought into this world. He puts a veil so people cannot see what is there for
people, my beloved,
they're looking
for a way out. But the enemy has blinded them so that they do not see the light of God. They'll find themselves in the same situation.
The
same sin. They will wake up and say, today I don't want to do that anymore. Today I want to be better. But the darkness that is blinding them is not showing them a way out. They're trying to do it themselves. And for those of us who have the Lord, we know that Jesus is the way. We know that He is the light that we need. So put us out of darkness. And the enemy wants us to forget that. That's why you bombard us with problems. To suffocate you. So that the light of the Lord is not seen. So then we can perish. But I'm going to pray right now in Jesus' name. May every veil of the Lord that was placed on your life to stop you from experiencing the light of God. May it be torn. If you were blinded, especially if you come from a family that is cursed, that has darkness, every generation has wanted to carry that darkness so that nothing good comes out. That darkness is passed on. Generations upon generations, and no one is seeing the light. But I'm praying once again, if you were blinded, any parental spirit from anyone from your mother's side, from anyone from your father's side, from seeing the light of God, I declare right now in Jesus' name, your eyes are open in Jesus' name. Your eyes are open in Jesus' name to see the light of God. My beloved, we all are born with a star. And the star, we know it shines. And the enemy will do all to suffocate it
to fail,
so that you do not shine and are rendered powerless. But as the face of God is shining upon us right now, I declare right now in Jesus' name, every force that will suffocate our star, that will suffocate the light of God in your life, is falling right now.
Loco,
Jesus' name.
Au nom de Jésus.
The Bible tells us, my beloved, in the book of Acts
13,
you can read that whole story at home.
But
I'm
going to
give you a summary. Here the Bible speaks of Paul, and Paul, who at the time was known as Saul, and
Barnabas.
They had crossed over to an island to preach the word of God to a governor. Now the Bible says there was someone who was good friends with the governor. His name was Bar-Jesus. And in some versions they say he's a magician, or they call him a sorcerer. But wherever he was, it was not good. Now the Bible says that Paul and Barnabas, they went to him so that, because he wanted to hear the word of God. But Bar-Jesus, they also call him Elmas.
Elmas,
he didn't want the light, the governor to receive the light. But in that moment,
Paul,
suddenly he's filled with the Holy Spirit. And when we say the Holy Spirit, he's filled with the light of God, and he rebukes, and he blinds,
but
Jesus. What am I trying to say, my
beloved?
May the light of God in you shine so brightly that every evil eye, that every sorcerer, that every magician, every demon, every principality, that wanted to hold your life, that wanted to stop your progress, may they be blinded. The light of God to shine upon us. We know that when something is a light, I remember the father of the house said it. He said, "Do you want anointing? Know that it pulls what is good and what is bad." And that's the light of the Lord. It will attract what is good. But the evil eyes will also be looking to you. But we are praying once again that every single one of those eyes, my beloved, to be blinded in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Now there are people who physically, they can see physically, but spiritually they're in darkness. It's not everyone that you see walking, they're walking in the light of God. You're seeing them living, breathing, laughing, doing all
things.
But spiritually, they are in darkness. So they can put on their makeup, they can cut their hair, they can wear whatever designer that they want, but they will have no impact in this world. When we are asking for God to make us shine, we are speaking spiritually, because it's spiritually we are walking in God's light. Spiritually we are shining.
So spiritually,
it is then reflected on the outside.
And
if you're in darkness spiritually, darkness will also reign physically in your life. Because you know that the spiritual realm has an impact on the physical. But the physical don't impact the spirit. That's why I said to you, you can see someone dressing nice, but in darkness, they're in darkness. spiritually.
But
in this ministry, we don't want people who are in darkness spiritually. We want people who are walking in the light of God. So that light inside of us, it will reflect on the outside and touch others and touch lives. My beloved, you want the Lord's face to shine upon you. When the Lord says to shine upon you, people will ask you, what is it that you do? What beauty regime do you have? Especially if you go on social media, you see people's night regime.
It's
like five things that they put so that in the morning they'll be shining. But you are not
going to
be doing the beauty regime. The regime that you need is the light of God in your life. It's not cocoa butter.
It's not cocoa butter day.
It's not Caroline today.
It's not Caroline.
It is the light of God.
It is the light of
God. It is the light of the Lord. It's not cocoa butter day.
It is not cocoa butter.
You know when I see my siblings,
when we talk about kabaleki na ngai,
pakuli mafuta,
they will cream themselves.
And they're shining.
And they feel the mangoes on
gega. And I'm like, hey. He primed everything.
But
I'll be like, no, we don't want our face to get dry. But the light that I'm speaking of, my beloved, it never dries out. And she said that she had a meeting with the manager. And in that meeting, the manager said, whatever they had spoken about, I can't remember. But she said that the manager said to me and another girl who started with me, that we didn't have any experience. But there was something in her that said to her that she needs to take us. There was something in her that said that I can't take away these opportunities to this girl. Even though they have no experience. When you have the light of God, my beloved, even if you do not have it, that light, like I said, it will impact other people. And they will be opening up opportunities to you. You will see favors upon your life because the face of God is shining upon you. And I pray right now, when you go out into the world, may the favorable face of God follow you where you go. As the light of the Lord is shining upon your life, may it touch the hearts of those who see them and push them to open doors, to push them to look favorably unto you, to push them to consider you, to push them to look unto you because of the light of God. Very soon I'm finishing up, my beloved. The Bible tells us in Matthew 5, verses 14 to 15, it tells us that a light, it cannot be hidden under a bowl. It must stand on a lampstand, giving light to the whole house. So I say again, my beloved, as we're going through this world, may the light of the Lord shine upon you. May it be on the lampstand, bringing life to your family, bringing life to you, whether you look at it. In Jesus' mighty name, you cannot hide the light of God. When I was writing this, I thought of the testimony that the father of the house gave on behalf of the first lady. He said that she had been promoted, and the people, the women, she was murmuring. But when she heard her speak, she said, truly, this woman knows what she's talking about. I'm trying to say, if you have the light of God, even if today they don't want to admit it, even if tomorrow they don't want to say, that light will be so bright that they will have to they will have to truly say, Lord, truly this person is of the Lord. And I pray whoever will encounter you will say, no, truly this woman, this man, this child belongs to the Lord. Because what I see shining from them, it can only come from the Almighty Lord. Can we please applaud for the glory of the Lord? What stops God's light shining upon us, my beloved? Is sin. It suffocates the light of God in our lives. And it puts us into darkness. We're going to quickly read Proverbs 2, verse 13. From those who leave the path of uprightness to walk in the ways of darkness,
amen.
Amen. So here the word is saying that when you walk away from the path of righteousness, you are walking in darkness. Means that when you're walking in sin, when you're walking contrary to the Lord, you are walking in darkness. What else suffocates us, man? It stops the light of God shining. Is if you're far from God. He is the source of life. He is the source of that life that you need. So if you are far from the source, how will you benefit from that life? The Bible speaks of the prodigal son. He wanted his dad to give him all his inheritance. He went. He squandered it all. But he forgot that he should have stayed with the source. And that's the same with us. What stops us from seeing the Lord's light in our lives is that we are far from Him. We must walk near Him. We need to be beneath His feet so that we can experience it. Another thing, my beloved, that can stop us from experiencing the Lord's light is our attitude. Or the families that we come from. Like I said before, darkness will be reigning. And generations upon generations, they think it's normal. But we are praying today that if that was us, that darkness is stopping with us in Jesus' name. And the light of the Lord is beginning. Now finally, I'll tell you, I've spoken about the light of God. I've spoken about the Lord's light shining. Maybe you want to know, how would this be possible? The first utmost thing is to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and as your Savior, because He is the light of this world. I've just said before, some people are in darkness because of the families they come from. But when you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, even if you come from a cursed family, even if you come from a family that's in darkness, even if you come from a family full of sorcerers, even if you come from a family filled with witches, the light of God will set you apart. The light of God will separate you from it. And you will be free to walk as the Lord wants for you to walk. You will be free to serve the Lord just as you want to serve Him, in Jesus' name. If you want to shine, my beloved, you must walk in holiness. We're going to go to Philippians 2:15. I'm going to read this quickly because I want us to pray. The Bible says, so that you may prove, I'm going to read a different version. This is the New Living Translation. Brother, Philippians 2:15. Here the Bible says, so that no one can criticize you, live clean, innocent lives as children of God, shining like bright lights in a world full of crooked and perverse people. If you want to see the light of God in your life, you must walk in holiness, my beloved. You must walk in purity, my beloved. You cannot attach yourself to what is perverse, to what is of darkness, especially in this world. Everything that we see is perverted, perverse. You turn on your TV, it's perverse. You scroll scroll on social media is diverse. But God is saying, even in the midst of all that, you need to walk in holiness so that you can shine as you go through the world. The third, my beloved, you must be in God's presence. You can read this at home. Exodus 34,
Exode 34,
verses 28 to 29. And here the Bible speaks of Moses. Moses was on the mountain praying to God, seeking God. He spent time in God's presence. And then when he came down from the mountain, the Bible says that his face shone so bright, because he was in the presence of God. He shone so bright, he was so radiant, that the people of Israel, they were even afraid to look at him. And I want to say right now, as you seek the Lord, as you enter into his presence, as you pray unto him, as you surrender your life unto him, may he cause your face to shine. May he cause your children's face to shine. May he cause your husband's face to shine. May he cause your wife's face to shine. May he make the children of this ministry, may we shine in Jesus' name. The Bible says that they could not approach Moses because he was shining so bright. He had to give them authority. He called them and said that they could come. And I say, as you shine brightly with the Lord, as you shine brightly for Christ, may not just anyone be able to approach you. Because you are shining in the light of God. You have the authority to control who will enter into your life, who will enter into your presence. May not just anyone come anyhow and do whatever. In Jesus' name. And finally, if you want to experience the light of the Lord, you need the Holy Spirit. The Bible tells us in the book of Matthew 25. You can read that at home. It speaks of the 10 virgin women. And they were all waiting for the coming of the bride, the bridegroom. And the Bible says, the Bible separates them. There were those who were wise. There were those and those who were foolish. Now the wise women, they had the spare oil that was needed so that their lamp could be lit. And when we are saying this, it is the Holy Spirit that we need, that is like the oil, so that the lamp could be lit. The Bible says that when the bridegroom, when the coming of the bridegroom was heard, the five wives, they had their spare oil and they were able to light the way so that they could enter to where the bridegroom was. And the five foolish, they went to buy it, but it was too late. My beloved, the way the world is going, with the things that we are seeing, we know that the bridegroom is on the way. We know that the bridegroom is soon to come. And if you want to be in the light of God, you need the Holy Spirit in your life. Because the Holy Spirit will guide you, will lead you, so that you can overcome anything in your way, so that you can enter to where the the bridegroom is. Because yes, we want to see the lights of the Lord in our lives. But the ultimate goal is for us to be by Jesus' side. It's for us to be by Him. And I pray, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus, may the Holy Spirit be manifested in your life, and the light of the Lord to be manifested in your life, in Jesus' name, so that when the bridegroom is to come, you will be by His side. Stand up right now, we are going to pray. We're going to pray right now, my beloved. We are going to pray right now. We are praying. We are asking for the Lord to be our light. We want to see Him, my beloved. This world of darkness, we do not want to be consumed by it. Be concentrated where you are.
Zala concentré, bien-aimé.
Pardon, Shine, parce qu'on a dit, Saint-Esprit,
Lumière et name every area you want the light of the Lord.
Tanga domaine nyoso to esika nyoso ligi lumière et nzambe kota na bomwe.
Whether be your children.
Soke zali bana na yo.
Your husband.
Soke zali mobali na yo.
Your wife.
Soke zali mwasi na yo.
Your mother.
Soke zali mama na yo. Papa na yo.
Your family.
Famille na yo.
Declare the light of the Lord.
Jesus'
name we pray. Jésus, donc il est dans le roi des rois, dans le nom puissant, glorieux de Jésus. That you are blessed. Lift your right hand side. Pray for our sister. May the Lord continue to shine upon her life. May the Lord continue to use her powerfully. Lift your voice, start praying now in Jesus' name. Bondela pona ser derbi. To tiki mwana na yo derbi no kana maboko na yo. To seigneur nga na vina ye o utilize ye puissamment a impacté na génération na ye azan na loko de a shine angenda na misala na ye na ba projet na ye na vina ye spirituel yawe kengisa ye sana ya kokamwa a distingue yawe ya kobunda le soute yondo kobundela ye pe victoire ezali ya ye na kombo na Yesu Christo bondeli tolobi amen. Yo to la dibiso na television na solelo. Tika ete toza na posa bomi comme c'est belé na YouTube na biso. We want for you to subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Chaque fois tant tocha ba message ba linga msupi ba bénéficier.
Every time we put messages others to benefit.
Église o comme na mon vessel of the ministry.
This church is called the vessel of the ministry.
Tika ete ba coordonner na biso za liwana.
Our bank account details are there.
Non, non, non. Ba coordonner ka adresse église.
Our address is there.
So ki ozana problème numéro de téléphone des aliwa.
If you have a problem on mobile number.
Toza pena email des aliwa.
Our email address is there.
So ko zai siko bonde la rate.
If you don't have a place.
Tozo lo ke siko bonde la.
Or you're looking for a place.
Oza la adresse malon pona.
This is a good address.
Oza la décité.
You will not be disappointed.
Zamba opa mola yo.
God will bless you.
Tika ete jeudi prochain.
May next Thursday.
Bola na biso susu.
Follow us.
À partir de 18h30 jusqu'à
6:30 p.m.
Zamba opa mola bino.
May the Lord bless you.
Otika la na kimia.
Remaining.
Bye bye au nom de Jésus.